Thanks. I'm Tolpai Melinda. I'm originally from Romania, but I live from over than 14 years in Hungary. My nationality is Hungarian, but my birthplace is Romania. And I always wish to come in Hungary because this is my nationality. And I always wished a Hungarian breed, but for me, from my childhood, Kuvas was my dream dog breed. And but my partner, who has children, he didn't let Kuvas. He insists to have a Commodore for guarding because his children, and everybody knows that Commodore is very good with children, and this is the reason why we chose finally Commodore and not Kuvas.
For people who are not familiar with this breed, can you tell us a little bit more about them?
Yes, Commodore is a special breed. If you see his appearance, he obviously see how special it is. They are very lovely, very good family dogs. Of course, they was bred to guarding livestock, and their guardian instinct is naturally, and we hope that it will never gone. So this instinct need to be in the breed, but the lifestyle of the owner and the practice, how his get used his dog to other people, to other dogs, to go in the city, to go to take to walk, make a little bit different behavior. This kind of guarding mm-hmm. It's come in their natural lifestyle. So if you keep the Commodore in the farm and do not let to see so many people, the guardian instinct will be much better. If you take with you in the city and let other people to see and play with him from the beginning at the puppy, of course they will be nicer with strangers, because they are get used to be nice with the strangers. But their unique look and the coat, which makes the people to like or to not like the dog, it is very beautiful. For the show dog is spectacular, and it is not so much hard work like for the first time when you see. Do you imagine? They not need very often to be washed. They have a natural their coat is easy to keep clean, as if you can keep dry. So the dry Commodore coat is almost always clean. So when they are get wet, this is comes the problem. But the coat is unique, and the matting is coming around 1 year old. So after 1 year old, you have to separate the cords one by one and by hand. So it's for the dog is like a playtime. Because time to time go and play with the dogs and make some cords, and the next day again some cords making, and it is funny for him, so it's not hurting, and it's a time to spend together. They will like it to make the cords. And after you finish all the body to make the cords one by one, you need to check only time to time. As much as growing the cords, you need to separate the new centimeters. Mm-hmm. And my suggestion is that this beautiful cord and the total coat, it's good to keep around 4, maximum 5 years old. And after that, it's better to cut back a little bit the cords, because it used to be very heavy, and summertime can be dangerous, a full coat for a commodore. I used to keep my dogs in short coat after they finished the championships, because we are living in a 4-hectare farms. We have sheep. We need the guardian instinct of our dogs. But I like to present my dogs to the dog shows, to present my breeding progress from years to years. And after they finish the championships, which is around 3, 4, maybe 5 years, I used to cut back the coat. Mm-hmm. I know that it's much more spectacular as the long coat, and if somebody who has a smaller courtyard, and for them is easier to keep clean the dog, and each other lifestyle, it's okay to keep a long coat. But as I mentioned, we are living in the farm, and for us it's important for the dogs to have free to go outside and running, and summertime can be a few weeks very hot here in Hungary, and I do not want to risk at all. Mm-hmm. So originally the breed was used by farmers to protect their property and the livestock, and they did very well the job. So they have the instinct, they like to stay home. So they really like to protect their territory. So this is why for a puppy who wish to be a good show dog, or to be a very nice dog in the city, you need to get used from the beginning to take in the city with you. Because a commodore, if it's not familiar with other circumstances, around 1 year old, their instinct to like to stay only at home and to protect their territory, it's very deep. The number of the population is very small, so only a few breeders make efforts to breed this commodore breed, and the breed has some problems with the reproduction. This is a very important issue to resolve. I'm not a doctor. I don't know from where it's coming, but I can notice only that the problem with the reproduction is the problem of the breed. I consider it, and some of new breeders, I noticed that after a few litters, they think that they know everything and seeing their dogs perfect. And if you see your own dog perfect, you will not make progress. So the important is that the breeders to see their own problems in the breeding, and to take into consideration to make no one's dog is perfect, but everybody can do to be better and better. Our main activity is the dog shows. So as I told you, they like to stay at home, and we have plenty of 4 hectares, so they can run around and play. And I get 2, 3, sometimes 5 dogs together to play. So I have plenty of space to offer them to play and I play with them, of course, and so I do not need to take the too many walks because they have a lot of space to run free. And the dog shows are the main activity which we like to do together. So Commodore, the male Commodores can be really dominant, and generally the breed is has their own will and not so easy to train. So somebody who like to train the dog and go to school and make tricks and agility and dancing, dog dancing, the breed is not for them. The dog is a very good family dog. I recommend for families with children. And you need to be very consistent and to teach from the beginning what they may do and what may not to do. And you need to be the boss. Mm-hmm. So they are a giant breed and they are not aggressive, but you may not let them to be the boss in the family because it is not good.
Right.
Mm-hmm. To guard the territory. This is absolutely the main job. And and to be a family member, of course. Normally, the Hungary is the originary country. Mm-hmm. So the Hungarian Commodore standard is the main standard. The of course is separate for the female and the male. Mm-hmm. For the male, the minimum is 70 centimeter, the minimum of the height. And the maximum limit is it was 80. Right now, basically, is no limit. But after 80 centimeter, the looks is not so nice. Mm-hmm. So I have after 80 centimeters, maybe it is too long legs. Mm-hmm. And it's not so nice. So you need to have a very strong body to look nice after 80 centimeters. So 50, it's a very very 10 centimeters is a lot. So a 70 centimeter is also a Commodore, and 80 centimeters is also a Commodore. Mm-hmm. Take into the consideration that this is a giant big. The maximum is the better to achieve, not the minimum. Mm-hmm. And for the female is from 65 centimeter, and it is absolutely the minimum for the Commodore. Mm-hmm. And in the kilo for the males is at least 50, really at least. Mm-hmm. And for the females it's at least the 40 kilogram. My females are over 50, everybody, and the males is absolutely over 40, absolutely over 40 kilograms.
What does health testing mean to your program? How important is it to you?
For me, it is important from the beginning. I made for all my breeding dogs, which are living with me, the hip test. Unfortunately, actually, in Hungary, it is not obligatory for breeding. So I did from 10 years old. From 10 years ago, I'm still testing my dogs because for me it is important. Even for start to breeding in Hungary, it is not necessary right now. Mm-hmm. Maybe in the future will change. because in I have dogs all over the world, and I noticed that they was tested for DM2, degenerative problems. I start to do this test also. But my bloodline is mostly tested anyway, because from my owners I get the good results. I think that close breeding is absolutely not good for the breed, because this small number of population. I think that different bloodlines, it's important in breeding. But the fact is that I have one female which excellent results and excellent looks, and I had my first male who is the standard for me when I wish to see almost perfect Commodore. I always seeing him. I try to make some line breeding, but not close. Right. It is excluded close. One of the problem is that, of course, everybody wish to see a giant Commodore, because this is a spectacular. But it's hard to have a giant size with correct legs. So when the size is very high, we have incorrect legs. So the big issue is to have big Commodores with correct legs. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And of course, for a big body, you need a really big head. This is important. I very upset when I see male Commodores with a small head. Mm-hmm. This is absolutely not preferable. So it's important to have the male to be muscular. Mm-hmm. So when I see males who it's not obviously for the first sight that they are male, it is important. It is very problematic for me. Mm-hmm. As soon as the vaccinations let to take out, and it is safe for the puppy. So if all the vaccinations is done, and you may take with you, as soon as it's very important, take into consideration that the 9 months old Commodore, it is has almost the adult size. So it's not so funny to get used the 9 months old Commodore to jump in the car and to be nice on the leash. So one side because the good socialization, and the other side because they are giant size, it's good as soon as possible. Oh, everything. Mm-hmm. Absolutely everything. Of course, I checking the teeth. I checking the pigmentation. I'm checking the legs to be correct. The body proportion to not be a long or short. This is very important. Other very important, the tail. The tail to be long enough and to not be high, to not wear high. So the tail is also a problem of the Commodore, and because we have a small number of the breeding dogs, many breeders don't take a few standards very very. They're not so important. So. If I keep a Commodore for myself, I'm really checking everything, and something is not good enough, I prefer to give for hobby. Mm-hmm. Of course, choosing a Commodore at 8 or 12 weeks old can make you a big surprise at 1 year old. Right. So right. Basically, a final decision you can take around 1 year old. Mm-hmm. But a good pigmentation, a good taste, a good proportion, you can see at 8-9 weeks old. In my kennel, mm-hmm. I have a few very excellent dogs, and I try to line breed with that bloodline. And also, I'm really doing my best always each year to find new bloodlines too. So if somebody has a really, really excellent dog, you need to keep the bloodline. But I'm absolutely not for close breeding, absolutely not. They like, of course, very much meat, so I give raw meat, and I have a very good type of dog food, so nothing special, because the Commodore does not need special diet. They was a very poor people dogs, so they are not allergic at all. They need good food for the first year, of course, for their development. It's normally, but after and to have a good coat, a quality coat, if of course is a partly generatic, and other side you need the quality food, of course. They are very special and very lovely, and I can recommend to families. And I think that their needs, it's absolutely for every owners who has a dog, to take care, to take good care, to socialize, to take care of the coats. So they has absolutely not extra needs. Beside the other breeds, and they are very lovely and acting by love. So they will do if something asks from them, less for the food, more by love. So when you ask something from the Commodore, he will do it because he loves you so much. I have a Poolie from 8 years. And I wish the smaller breed. I wish the smaller breed next to my Commodores, and I wish to be a Hungarian one. And between the Poolie, Pumi, and Moody, I consider the Poolie the nicer, especially because the coats are basically the same like the Commodore, and they are very clever. And very, very devoted to the owners. They like to stay next to you all the times, and they are funny. So I chose Poolie because they are so funny and clever. Yes, the Poolie was bred to herding the livestock, and they need a lot of possibility to run and to run free. Even with this character, they are good to keep in the house, because they love to stay next to you. So if you can offer enough exercise day by day, they are good to live with you in the house, no problem. The problem is that usually they like to bark a lot and for everything. So this, only this is a little bit problem for me. Maybe for others not. The Commodore is not barking without reason. If you hear your Commodore's barking, it's better to go out and to look why. Because without reason, he is not barking. But when you have a Poolie, they can bark for everything.
Right.
So be careful if your neighbor is will accept this little problem. Yes, I had just a few liters. I have not so much experience with Poolies, but I saw so many good breeders in Hungary, and I saw so many good and almost excellent dogs. I saw the Poolie breeding much easier, because the number of the quality dogs is really huge. So it's very easy to breed. It's easy. They has not this kind of problem like I mentioned to the commodores with the or I cannot see the problem with the police regarding the reproduction, so they can easier reproducing, and they are very good mothers, and the breed has very a lot of very good breeding dogs. The mares is maximum 45 centimeters, and I think around 15 kilogram, females around 10 kilogram, and around 40 centimeter. Mm-hmm. I have the same activity like with the commodores, that we have free time and a lot of space at home. Sometimes I'm using my pulleys to herding. We have sheep, and their instinct to herding the sheep I can use sometimes when I need. But pulley is very good for people who has agility and dog dancing plans. So they are fit for this kind of sports. So pulley is good for dog dancing and for agility. Mm-hmm. Oh, basically everybody. Mm-hmm. who can accept the long coat, which is not shedding. So it's absolutely very nice to live with the pulley or the commodores because they are not shedding. And pulley is absolutely fit for everybody, basically. Absolutely nothing. They are totally different. Only the coat type, which is unique on the world, the coat type is similar, but nothing else.
Commodores are much more serious, right?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I hear pulleys are pretty hardy as well, though, that they're kind of a tough dog as well.
They are very active, and they have some good guardian instinct, too. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I wish I have a lot of breeds, especially giant breeds. Maybe I wish to have in the future, but... it's not exactly. A Tibetan Mastiff is very, very on the top on the list for me, because they are very beautiful, and I watch what I read about their temperament is a little bit similar with the Commodore. Mm-hmm. So this is why it's interesting for me the most, maybe. But I have so many breeds which I like, so I better don't think about to have another breed because I wish too much. I maybe the Spitz.
Okay. Yeah.
Because they are looking funny.
Yeah.
But from my childhood, I always was interesting about the giant breeds. Uh-huh. When I think about the dog. A dog for me, it's from the medium size and plus.
Really?
I like this type of dogs, giants. Mm-hmm. I wish to thank you for the honor to choosing me, and I'm sorry that my English is not so good. It's very hard to explain myself in foreign language.
Oh no, you did great. You did great. Your English is 100% better than my Hungarian or Romanian.
I'm sure.
I learned the voice. Valhalla. Nature's laws I learned to see were mirrored in mythology. Family fought the will to be, now stirred my racial soul. Leave off my race, leave on. I'm thinking of my younger days. Leave off my race, leave on. The guidance of my people's ways.